Well, it's a really important problem and challenge for economic, for small business startups. And I actually first experienced that. Well, when I was mayor, we had a big issue with getting just fiber into our city. And it was not AT&T, it was another provider that we didn't have enough, like we didn't have a university or a hospital, like we didn't have the big users. And so, but we had this big business park with some land, and we actually had an opportunity for a really good business. And the only reason we didn't come is because we didn't have the fiber. And that was kind of, for me, as that was like, how do we get it? I mean, I was calling their corporate headquarters, the whole thing, no movement on it. And then the other thing that was a commercial realtor, I worked with several folks who were working at their house but couldn't do their jobs. And so they ended up renting a single room in the city of Saline so they could actually get access to it. Now, this was back to probably, the mid-2000s, 2007, 2008-ish. So it's been a while. So it's probably a little bit better, but it is continuing to be, especially because now there's more and more usage and it's being used differently with the video. I know there's capacity issues because I know, I would talk to AT&T about my district and they're like, we're investing in Ann Arbor. I'm like, come on out here. Well, so anyhow, that because there's so much usage with the video and that way, I don't think that there was a good understanding. And this is back to the technology, how fast things change, because I don't think there's good understanding of usage that people were going to be watching videos. And so the capacity is filling up pretty quickly at certain times of day. So that's pretty challenging for us. But it's definitely on my list of concerns. And I have a lot of constituents that are really upset about access to either the quality, no access or lack of reliability. Cost is somewhat of a factor because I think, it can be so prohibitive if you're not in the right location. And then the speed, like data caps and stuff. Do you have certain areas, or are you just coming to listen?
I'm coming to listen, no.
Okay, great. Well, we appreciate you're here.
Just had a quick glance and thought I'd come by.
I appreciate it. That's great. Yeah.
Sorry, there's one more thing. With the plant issue, there's a couple of things. I know Tide sends these packets across to Africa. I was wondering if those packets, could they sort out the iron, first of all, and could we send those packets to plant?
What are the packets?
Purification, water purifier.
Oh, filters? Oh, well, I know they are putting filters in Flint, it's bad. I know they're putting filters in. I think right now what I'm hearing is the filters are not lasting more than a couple of weeks because the water's so bad. So I think really right now they just need to not use the water. And that's one thing we're going to do is figure out ways to hopefully get more water there. And I know that the governors, but me individually as a person and my constituents, what can we do to help? I know there's a lot of people around the state and the country that want to help. And from what I'm hearing, it seems more like it's not even about, the filters are good, but they need water, good water, not, the filters are not lasting very long, according to what I'm hearing. So, of course, a filter water is better than what they currently have. But that's I'll bring that back because I know now that it's at a much higher level of concern, there's a lot more attention, and I think there'll be some money invested in really addressing a lot of those issues and hopefully really fixing it.
The other question is, and I know this is pretty much the local level for the government, the governor, is will there be more investigation towards and balances towards these? I know Flint was put in charge by a government.
Yeah, I know there's going to probably be some. I know the Attorney General announced this morning that they were going to do something about an investigation as to whether state laws have been broken. they're looking at it. I think there's multiple groups looking at it, not just government.
Because I know that there has been people put in charge, like in Detroit, for the school districts and stuff like that. I also think that the people should be balances because of the school district, because of Flint, that there should be checks and balances for those people, not
yeah. Yeah, there's lack of accountability for emergency managers. It's a challenge, I think, that our states will, you know, hopefully some of the, I mean, this is a terrible, terrible tragedy what happened with Flint, but I think it also will help document, you know, as a former mayor, I think that for somebody to come in and have no accountability to anybody at the local level is a tragedy. And shouldn't happen. And I think that this tragedy that happened will reinforce that, and hopefully we won't have this kind of situation ever again. I can't guarantee that, but I think if you don't learn from your history and from the mistakes that happened, we have a civilization that's never going to survive.
I think that's also a situation of underinvestment in infrastructure.
Yeah.
But, you know, those pipes have been old for a long time and should have been replaced a long time.
Yeah, but what the Flint River, I think, is highly polluted, and
yeah.
So I don't know if you've heard, but like Jam wasn't even using, they stopped using Flint water because it was corroding their parts. I mean, this is not a new problem,
right.
And that's kind of why I think we have a much bigger problem. Mm-hmm. You know, ultimately, I think we'll learn more over time, but what I learned recently was that Jam actually, when they had their plant up there, they stopped using much water because it was actually corroding their parts so badly. That was the same water that, because so
someone would have checked that before they switched the water.
Yeah, so you know, there's a lot of stuff out there. So right. I guess for me, it's clear there's a huge problem that happened. Mm-hmm. And again, I think we need to learn. If something happened and it didn't work, you know, because there wasn't enough accountability, which is what it sounds like is, you know, happening here. And of course, it's like everything else. We need to continue to look into it and have somebody that has an independent. For me, this is always about having an independent point of view and not an internal investigation.
Right.
There was several audits. I mean, there was an audit and trainer, and then also the governor's task force. That task force there is definitely there's a challenge there that we have to address. So
That's another thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like are you gonna investigate and plan because of the roads, because of the infrastructure? Investigate. I know the bridges have to be investigated.
Yeah.
But